Greetings, friends. This video will cover the fundamentals of Direct Online Starter, including its operation. A Direct Online, DOL, starter is a type of electrical motor starter that is commonly used to start and stop three-phase induction motors. It is a simple and cost-effective solution that provides a direct connection to the motor windings without any external control circuitry. The essential components of a DOL starter used for motor control include a three-pole MCB or MCCB, a contactor, an overload relay, and start-stop buttons. Additionally, for control purposes, single-pole MCB, stop, run, and trip indicators are used. The three-phase supply lines, L1, L2, and L3, are connected to the three-pole MCB, and its output is linked to the contactor. The supply line then goes through the overload relay before reaching the induction motor. These components are connected in series to ensure efficient operation. To control the motor, a phase is taken from the incoming phases and given to a 2A MCB. In the diagram provided, the blue phase is used. The output of this MCB is connected to the contactor coil A2 terminal. Another wire is taken and linked to the trip indicator lamp on one side, while looping the run and stop indicator lamps on one side with a wire. In this DOL starter, the neutral wire is connected to the normally open auxiliary contact of the magnetic contactor and looped with the normally closed contact of the magnetic contactor, the 98 and 95 contacts of the overload relay. The 98 is an auxiliary normally open contact of the overload relay with 97 contacts. 95 is the normally closed auxiliary contact of the overload relay with 96. Some overload relays have only three terminals, namely 95, 96, and 98. Terminal 96 serves as the common terminal, while terminal 95 is the normally closed contact and terminal 98 is the normally open contact. It should be noted that the stop push button typically has normally closed contacts that open when pressed. Conversely, the start push button normally opens contacts that close when pressed. The wire from the 96 contacts is connected to the stop push button's first terminal. The second terminal of the stop push button is connected to the first terminal of the start push button. The wire then goes from the second terminal of the start push button to the normally open auxiliary contact of the magnetic contactor and loops the contactor coil terminal A1 with this. Another wire is taken from the stop push button's second terminal or from the start push button's first terminal and connected to the auxiliary open contact of the contactor as shown in the video. As shown in the video, a light blue wire is taken from the normally open auxiliary contact of the overload and linked to the second terminal of the trip indicator lamp. This light will illuminate if the overload relay trips. As shown in the video, a dark green wire is taken from the auxiliary open contact of the magnetic contactor and linked to the second terminal of the run indicator. This light will illuminate if the motor is running. As shown in the video, a dark brown wire is taken from the normally close auxiliary contact of the contactor and linked to the second terminal of the stop indicator lamp. This light will illuminate if the motor is in a stop condition. When we press the start push button, the contactor closes, allowing the motor to be connected directly to the power supply. The overload relay monitors the current drawn by the motor and will trip the starter if the current exceeds a predetermined value. The advantages of using a DOL starter are that it is simple, reliable, and requires very little maintenance.